John Kovacovich, founder of agency SOS. It is Friday, July 2nd. We have now been open for 16 days, 17 days, something like that. I did one of these at the end of the first week, kind of a first week recap, and I heard from some folks that they really liked it. Hey, we like the transparency. We like the look behind the curtains. I also heard from people that said they didn't need 12 minutes from me, which is fair. So I'll try to keep this shorter. Anyway, here's a quick update as to what's been going on. Obviously, the big news is that we have merch. Well, we don't really have merch. I bought two of these, and they're giant for my big old head. So merch is probably an over. This is kind of SOS swag that we've got, and maybe it will turn into merch that will be available. The merch is selling. It should just be swag that I give away to people who want to be part of the SOS family. Maybe everybody on the bench, every bench buddy should get a hat. But right now there's two of them. I've been going on a daily walk every morning, and I'm always a little bit worried when I wear the hat that someone's going to call 911 because they think it's a cry for help. So people have asked, how's it going? What do you do all day when you have a new agency? What's cooking right now? So I thought I'd just give you a quick recap as to what this past week has looked like. I wrote down some notes, and I had 23 calls this week. Is that good? Is that a lot? Does that sound like I'm bragging about how busy I am? I had 23 calls. Now, 9 of them were related to current projects that I'm working on. I think I've mentioned this before, but the agency that I just left, Duncan Channon, terrific agency, the place where I've been ECD for the last 3 years, actually has me helping finish up one of the projects that we've been working on for Sweet Tarts, which is launching very soon on July 13th. Honestly, it's a project that's been years in the making. So I was able to stick around and kind of help see it across the finish line. DC, which was sad to see me go, has been also wildly supportive of SOS, and they completely understood why I wanted to give this a try. So it's been great to have them as one of the things I'm still working on as SOS is ramping up and I'm ramping down my time at DC. So that's still taking some of my time, and that was some of my meetings. I also have sort of my first SOS client that I'm working on, and we had a client presentation this week for that. And so that involved a couple of meetings. I also had 4 new business calls. Well, I had 3 new business calls, and that's going to turn into 3 proposals, which is exciting. The fourth is a really embarrassing story. I had put the calendar notice on my calendar, but I'd forgotten to add the client's email address. So nothing says I'm capable of handling your advertising business like the inability to schedule a basic meeting. So I was sitting there and wondering why he wasn't dialing in for our call when I realized that I f***ed it up. So I don't know that guy is going to be looking for a proposal from SOS. Hey, I made a mistake. I'm sorry. If you're listening to this, I would really love for you to call back and we could talk about your business, but I'm not going to hold my breath. The other cool thing is this week, I got my kind of first big RFP that I sent out, which was fun. I'm partnering with a production company to kind of put together a package for creative development and execution of a 3-spot package. And, you know, who knows? I mean, I'm sure we're one of a bazillion people that are sending in the RFP. But it was fun to put that together and have the creative idea and the strategy and the production package all in one thing. And, you know, you feel like a real agency when you're sending out proposals with your logo on it and stuff. So I'm excited about that. We'll know next week whether that happened, and fingers crossed that it turns into something. The rest of those 10 meetings were sort of a balance of kind of catch-up meetings with friends who wanted to hear about the new business. And but most of them were with potential talent partners, which was exciting. A number of folks have kind of reached out to see if they could be on the bench for agency SOS. I have some more of those set up next week. So again, the chicken and the egg thing with this agency is starting small, don't have a lot of employees. So I'm trying to build a bench of folks that I can call on. So when the opportunities come in, I can put together a little package and then get that business. And then we all win with the business. That's the theory. Anyway, what else? Do I have any other news to report? Oh, press. We got another lovely article this week about the theme song. The theme song is the gift that keeps on giving. There's a link at the bottom of the homepage, agencysos.com, where you can click on the articles if you want to see the articles. We've been getting press about the launch of the agency, which is really cool. So go there if you want to read that stuff. Oh, and we also sent out our third weekly newsletter today, our Three Things newsletter. If you're getting it, let me know what you think. Email me at john@agencysos.com. I would love feedback. You like it? You don't like it? More of something, less of something. The idea is just to be sort of three cool, creative things that can inspire marketers. So it's other ads or other stuff in the world that sort of is applicable to advertising. But I'd love any feedback. If you guys are getting it and you like it, let me know. If you're getting it and you hate it, let me know. And if you're not getting it, you really should go to agencysos.com and subscribe. It's short and it's good. It's good. You'll like it. Anyway, that's the report, the week three report, short and sweet. Hope you guys are doing great. Thanks for all the support. And if you know anybody that needs any help with their advertising, call Agency SOS. And if you see me out there walking around with this hat, don't dial 911. I'm going to be fine. Have a great 4th of July weekend.